Hello, I'm Claire Rinaldi. I am here today to challenge you to a 40 bags in 40 days decluttering and clearing the clutter with Claire. I am here to offer you this free mini course and guide you for the next 40 days to help clear out the clutter in your life and do it with intention and purpose and in bite-sized chunks. Welcome to part two of my free video series. If you haven't already, the PDF is linked below in the description. Go ahead and print that out if you wish and keep following along with this video. As you can see, there are two designated columns that I've created on the first page of your PDF download. The first column has a suggestion to designate a spot for your bags in your home. The reason I suggest this is because as you start your cluttering process, you don't want to start bagging your things and keeping them thinking that you're going to take care of it later. If you at least have a spot or an area designated, you know that once that area has been designated, you need to take action and remove those items from your home. It allows your brain to process it differently, as if you are really letting yourself, allowing it to let go. I also suggest that if you do have a car, to clean out the trunk of your car. This way, once you're ready to remove everything from the designated area, you have a spot to put it and you're not flustered as you're removing things on the fly. And trust me, I get it. I have a car full of kids, usually a stroller and miscellaneous other things. As you go along, you'll probably be stuffing bags around the kids if you're really trying to get rid of it, and that's okay too, but you know what? Let's at least try to have it as organized as possible. Once you've done that, just go around your house and gather as many reusable bags or some trash bags and empty boxes. Next, you're going to want to find a way to sort your items into piles, because as you go through your cluttering process, you're going to realize that you want to keep or donate or trash or maybe reconsider the idea of keeping or restoring some of these pieces. So if you have some bigger Amazon boxes laying around, just go ahead, sort them and label them with keep, donate, trash, and maybe. You will thank yourself later. As you go down the left column, you'll notice that I start with the kitchen. However, if you don't have the time to or the desire to start with the kitchen, you don't have to start there. You can pick the allotted area that you are focusing on for that chunk of time or for that time of day that you feel like doing your decluttering process. As you're filling up a bag or a box, I want you to first check in and really think about what you want to tackle. Do you have 15 minutes? Do you have 20 minutes? Do you have an hour? Or do you have a half a day or a full day? If you have 15 minutes, then I suggest starting with something small, such as one drawer or one flat surface that you know you can handle within 15 minutes, okay? The reason you want to start here is because you want to make sure that you are not setting yourself up for failure. If you set yourself up for failure, you're automatically just going to feel like you are defeating yourself, and then you are likely, just like someone like me, just wanting to give up, and you have lost sight of what's going on and why you're truly doing this. So, as I've referenced before in the first video, you may be starting right away with a goal and an intention for the ending of this project, or maybe you're just starting because I simply said to just start because you need to start somewhere. Either way is fine, okay? I want to make sure that I can reaffirm this with you as you go through this. Now, let's say you do choose to start with the kitchen. I want you to start with the utensil drawer. I know that sounds crazy to some people, but if you start here, you're going to realize how much more relief you have even the next day with your utensil drawer, because you go into that drawer to get your spoons, to get your forks, to get your knives, and if you are going through that and you are pushing against other junk that you don't need, you are actually self-sabotaging yourself in this area every single day more than you may realize. And I know that sounds like a lot, in some ways, but I'm telling you, it makes a big deal every single day. Now that you have cleaned out your utensils drawer, I want you to take the miscellaneous items that you no longer need and place them into the correct box or bag. Put it in keep or donate, trash or maybe. Believe it or not, there may be something in there that you think is sentimental. Maybe you've stumbled upon an old corkscrew or wine bottle opener that your mother gave you and you feel that it is useful. Maybe you don't drink wine, but maybe you want to entertain and you want to keep it as a memento. But maybe you're considering getting rid of it or passing it along to someone else. I know this sounds crazy, but it's not. It is something that most of us actually find attachment to. So if you want to, you can place it in the maybe pile. That way you can get used to the drawer having the things you need and not being filled with other things that you may not use on an everyday basis. And you are setting the intention that you are considering the idea of letting go and saying goodbye to that item. The same goes for dishes, flatware, any other things in your kitchen that maybe were given to you as a gift, but you have not used. Let's say you really need that top counter, the top of the counter to be clear, or you need that space up top because now your kids need space for lunch boxes. You need the flow of your day to be designated in your kitchen. And if you have flatware and stuff that's not being used, you can either one, store it someplace else nicely, or you can consider saying goodbye to it and moving forward. It's okay to part with gifts. Even if they were given to you with good intention, you're also letting go of some items knowing that you were accepting of it and needing it at the time, but maybe it's okay for someone else to receive this because you're saying goodbye to it. As I continue releasing videos in this series, I will be giving suggestions on how you can create separate stations that work ideally for your family. Like, for example, I allow my kids to have certain snacks without me having to give permission for them to have it. So you may at some point designate a refrigerator drawer or continue and make a snack basket or come up with a cart that's specifically designated for them to do what they need to do throughout the day. But you cannot do that without getting clear about what you have in your pantry or your cabinets or your cupboards. You need to evaluate and take inventory so that you can get on track with what you want to do throughout your day. And this will also benefit a proper meal prepping and meal planning phase for you or your family. So when you go ahead and you get into the pantry or your cabinet where you store most of your canned goods and cereals and pastas and grains, this is a good idea to have a decent chunk of time available to you so that you can really evaluate what you want to store and what you want to toss. Because if you have 15 minutes, you're not going to get to go through an entire cabinet of things that you've been holding onto for no reason. Unless you get to a point where you have a minimum amount of stuff because you want to resupply. And some people do different eating plans like pantry shelf cooking where you cook until everything is bare, which is a zero-based budget method. And that's really helpful and something for many of us to consider, even with no matter what size family you have and what budget you have, it's something to consider. However, you can't really get there if you don't get clear on your pantry status. So part of your decluttering mission is to go through and see, are there expired items in my closet? Can I get rid of those? Do I really shop and use canned goods, or do I prefer using bagged beans as opposed to canned beans and soups? Just go ahead, toss what no longer works, donate what you can, because food pantries will always accept food, especially cat and dog food too. Keep in mind that those are available to donate as well. And continue to go through and just get it to a point where you are happy with what you're looking at. Now, you don't have to make it Pinterest perfect right now. You're just going through and removing what no longer serves you, okay? Keep that in mind. I'm moving forward and I want to remove only what no longer serves me. As we continue to go down the left column, You'll notice I have suggested the living room or family room. This is an area where you will spend a lot of your time throughout the day, right? Maybe after dinner, you guys sit down and you are watching TV. Believe it or not, if you are sitting down trying to relax and feel good about the ending of your day, and you have a constant feeling of something that needs to be done, it may absolutely have to do with things that are buried and stored in your computer stand, your TV stand, underneath the couch, things like that that you're feeling that you don't realize because you just can't see them. Whatever doesn't feel good and you have the appropriate amount of time to try to tackle, try to go to that area so that you can get an idea of how you truly want to feel in your living space and family room. Maybe it's a bookshelf that's just overwhelmed with books and tchotchkes and things of that nature that you just don't want to deal with. If there are things there that have a sentimental attachment to, set them aside into your maybe box or pile and make the choice that you're going to come back and revisit those items. Maybe you have a blanket that you really like and you want it to get repaired, but you haven't done anything to it, so you need to find a seamstress. Go ahead, find a designated area to place that, because that's going to be something you're going to place on your to-do list. Maybe your kids' toys are overwhelming you. This can be an entire category in itself. However, temporarily, you're going to want to go through, get rid of what's broken, and designate the rest into a basket so that when you get to the kids' toys and playroom, you're going through all the kids' toys at once and you're doing it with your kids together. Electronics, cords, and phones can go in their own category. You'll can see that that's over on the right side at the bottom. And believe it or not, I am going to suggest that you may have some sentimental attachment to some of these things. Believe it or not, even if it is just technology, you may associate some sort of memory with these things. Make sure you separate what's usable to donate, place it there, and then if you have some sort of sentimental attachment, you can make a decision as long as you feel it's best for you, or set it in the sentimental category. Go through, bundle up your electronics, your cords, and your phone chargers, and place it all into one area. I think the ideal situation and is ideal solution to these situations typically is that we have these things all over our house. Consider designating one area for all of these items. As you go through the rest of this challenge and you're going through each designated area, tackle what's bothering you the most. Is it something that's blocking you as soon as you walk into the door? Is it your hallway? Is it your entrance? Is it a door? Is it that your kids don't hang up their coats, their shoes, your husband doesn't put his workout gear away? Designate areas for these things and just ruthlessly say goodbye to some of these things that are no longer serving you. If you have too many coats, go ahead, donate those, because somebody else will need them because you're saying goodbye to them. When you go through your closets, you know, go through and say goodbye to duplicates. And it doesn't mean that you won't have something else come back to you when you need it. Your laundry room or your utility closet should have some sort of flow and function to it at some point in the future, okay? You don't have to stress out about it right now, but you do want to start discarding things that don't feel good. And if you have extra canisters and containers, you make sure you discard them in a safe manner. The same for when you tackle your bathroom. You want to go through your medicine cabinet and make sure you're getting rid of things that are expired and you're getting rid of them the appropriate way. This way, as you're going through your linen closet, your laundry room, and your bathroom, you're also taking inventory of the zillion things that you're coming across. Maybe you have plenty of toothbrushes, you keep buying them for some reason. That's something that you may want to put down on a list or take off your list that you have of something to get. This is saving you money by saying no to things you already have. The same goes for makeup, hair products, and anything underneath the sink. When you get into your bedroom should feel comfortable for you at night. Make sure the bedding feels good to you. Go through your linen closets. Is there a better blanket in there that you like better? Then say goodbye to the one that you don't need any longer. You can donate those to dog shelters, and you can donate them in many places. So don't feel like somebody couldn't use that if you're having a hard time saying goodbye to those items. Accessories, shoes, coats, suits, belts, bags, and even suitcases. Just double check how these feel for you. Are you holding onto these for for something that's in the past. It's okay to let go, and I'm giving you permission as long as it feels good to you. If you're walking into your house and you have to go past your porch, does it feel good when you walk onto your porch? I know for me, we have had to redo it several times. And every time we redo it, even just by cleaning it, painting it, and removing all the junk and giving a recyclable area, a designated area, it always feels so much better. And I don't feel like I have 10,000 things jumping at me as I walk through the door. On the next page of your free printable PDF, I have a list of suggestions and ideas for each category, as well as goals and obstacles that you may need to consider as you're going through this process. In the goals box, I have a suggestion that you are maybe considering the idea of keeping only what feels good, making room for clarity, to become more efficient, not perfect, in your living situation. Implementing baby steps to get a routine and to feel good in your space. To not feel so overwhelmed with life or laundry. To maybe improve your finances or budgeting. Know what things I already own, because sometimes we overspend or overpurchase. Feeling good in my current space with less anxiety. Giving each space a purpose. Feeling more independence and freedom in my daily schedule, so I know what I'm coming home to and what I have to do in order to feel good, to feel less stuck. Those are some goals that I know that I have tried to achieve when I go through my space and go through our items in our house. And I think that those may be some of the things that bump up for each of you. In your plain version of this, I'll give you space so that you can come up with your own goals, but these may be some suggestions just so you can gain some clarity. You'll also notice in the corresponding box to the right, I have a box labeled obstacles. Some things that come up for me are the notion of not enough space, too much stuff and nowhere to put it, don't know where things are, or too much digging and looking, no defined areas and spaces. Maybe not enough money and can't be organized. Repeat purchases. Can't keep up with routines. I just don't feel good in my space. I don't like current paint or carpet colors. And being stuck in comparison. Ugh. These are just some ideas that you can think of when you're trying to review your current obstacles that you are trying to overcome. The next spot is... When you go to the next box that says inspiration and the one next to it in ideas for, you're going to come up with ideas as you start removing things from your space. You may realize that your designer closet that they're looking to have, you may not actually need. You may just need some new shelving, some shoe racks, and a couple of other things that you may have even found as you're decluttering in different spaces, which can therefore be used in that space. And then you can draw different inspiration by going onto Pinterest and getting some better ideas. So those are ideas that you can place in your inspiration and ideas for box. You may also just draw some inspiration from your favorite HGTV show or your favorite movie house or your favorite stores. But when you're doing that, keep an open mind that you are trying to declutter and remove things that you no longer serve you, and you're looking towards the future, but you don't want to go into comparison, because you want to make sure that where you currently are feels good, where you're making decisions and you can plan as you're not so much in the thick of the removal process. You can get inspired, but you want to keep going and remove as much as possible and then make those choices. You're going to get inspired to maybe even come up with better ideas for how you can use your space, like a sitting chair to sit in and to meditate. And then you realize that you can add in some fun things to your space, like some essential oils or your favorite book, or you found your favorite blanket in the family room, but you feel it goes best in your new reading chair. Fun things like this will come up. You may even notice as you go through different things that you found something you thought you lost, and that's really exciting. Then in the bottom, you're going to list all the things that you need to either get or replace, like shoe racks, like I mentioned, or a new doormat, maybe some new hooks to hang up some jewelry that you found in a drawer that you shoved everything into. you might need a meal planner for your refrigerator. Things like this will come out, and as you're out and about, you might not knowingly stumble upon those items and grab them because you're like, wow, I just realized I need this. Let me get that. And then you're going to make a list of things that you need to fix and or replace. And as you figure this out, you can jot it down here, because at least by jotting it down, you've set the intention that that's your next thing you're going to tackle. And instead of it whirling it around in your mind and constantly bugging you without you realizing it, you've at least put it down on a piece of paper so that you can tackle it later on. The next page of suggestions and ideas are some ways you can do a digital declutter, a car declutter, a garage declutter, which is always my favorite. That'll be on another episode. A paper declutter. And then, last but not least, all of the mementos and things that you have placed into that sentimental and maybe box. Let's go back to digital declutter. In the digital declutter, you're going to want to go into your email, look at your computer desktop, your contacts, your digital photos, your old technology, and then you want to say goodbye to things from the past that no longer serve you for the future, or matter to you right now, currently or presently. You may even want to consider going through your apps on your phone, or sort and organize how your phone feels to you. Trust me, that makes a huge difference. And as I go along this series, I will make some videos on how to go through each of these things and tackle them, 10 minutes a day, 15 minutes a day, 20 minutes a day. It makes such a huge difference in your life. A car declutter will also help you, because how you feel in your car, because you spend so much time in it, or maybe you take a train or you commute by bus, for you, you may want to consider how you pack your lunch, or how your bag feels, or how you wear your coat, like all the extra things that you have. You might want to organize what's with you, and then even at your work, how you feel when you get to work. How can you make your desk feel better? How can you make your surroundings feel better? How can you remove tons of clutter that you no longer need? Can you file those papers away that you keep meaning to file but you don't? Back to the car. For me, I know that I always have a garbage bag in the car, coins in a container, a vacuum on hand, and I try to have wipes so that I can wipe down the dust and all the everything else that's going on in the car. Because with kids, there's always something. And I always try to keep quarters on hand so we can just make a thing of it and go to the car wash and wash it, or to just go vacuum the car with the big, loud vacuums. The garage declutter, that is a huge project that may be take more time. Again, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. Same thing. You're going to remove duplicates, sort it into categories, create stations and storage ideas, schedule a free large donations pickup, and come up with a plan. And then you're going to make it a habit to put things back where they belong after doing so. Paper declutter is a whole other ballgame too, because if maybe some of us are really good at it, or some of us have a hard time with it. But again, this is a bit by bit challenge, and if you, as long as you get a grip of it, it'll begin to feel better for you. And the other box in the bottom here, again, is reminding you about the sentimental declutter. As you go through your decluttering, you're taking anything that is sentimental to you, setting it aside, and going back to that area. After decluttering for 40 days, come back to the sentimental. You will notice you totally may want to reconsider and letting go of more than you actually realize, because when you were making that decision initially to really hold on to it, you were making it because your energy was like, wow, I can't let go of all of this at once, so let me balance it out and let you think that I should hold on to this too. So once you come back to it in a neutral state, you'll be surprised at how you can let go of more. Again, you're gonna have a to fix pile, right? Now, I put that in a separate box again, because once you stumble upon things that you think you might want to fix, you may realize that you don't really want to fix those things, or you're okay with letting go with them, or you really do want to fix those things, but you know that in your schedule, you can't do that for the next 6 weeks. If you can't do that for the next 6 weeks, then make sure on the calendar you write it down after 6 weeks to check in and see if you can really do so. If this stuff continues to sit there for 3 months, that's a big chunk of time, And if you haven't been able to get that done within 3 months, again, reconsider the idea of moving forward or letting go of that project. Because once you make the decision to let go of that project, the next idea will come to you, and you never knew, you may not have realized that you had other ideas that were ready and willing for you to be handling. You may have been holding on to things that were no longer serving you, and now you're ready to accept the things that you can serve. Again, as long as you have a timeline and you've written it on the calendar, after 3 months, it may seem like a lot to some and not enough for others. It's time to say goodbye and move forward. You'll feel so much better if you've set some timelines and some goals to achieve, and then therefore deadlines, and you've moved forward and made choices that feel good to you. Another page is a page called My House Goals, and I think that that's appropriate to check in with after you've done a good amount of decluttering. But those pages, as you can see here, are blank and ready for you to fill in, and you can use my suggestions, or you could put anything that you feel makes sense for you, your routine, your goals, and your dreams, and how you want to feel in your space. And I wish you a ton of luck with this PDF. So now that we've gone over the PDF, I'm going to explain to you another little extra bonus that I may have for you that you may enjoy, or you can just choose not to, but it is an extra bonus for you. I have an MP3 down below, and it is something that has really helped me over the past several years when I realized that I feel as much as I feel, I can sense as much as I can sense, and it helps me with creating a habit and a routine throughout my day. That is 2 minutes and 3 minute MP3 guided meditations. I am super simple about it. It is not full of fluff. It's really clearing and healing for my energy. And as I was going through my decluttering process, like really heavily last year, I realized that, like, if I picked up like this, right? Like the feeling of intensity is there, even though it's just papers, right? It's just papers. You're just making choices about what to do with the papers, but there's this feeling that I felt, and it's just different vibration that you're experiencing with the paperwork, right? So for me, I knew that it was okay for me to not so much claim that it was anxiety or anything like that, because yes, I may have felt uncomfortable, but I knew that if I paused, took a break, and listened to my body and the information, and even like an MP3, I could recenter myself and then not feel so attached to the feeling of it feeling so enormous that I can't tackle it. And that helps me. So I've included that for a limited time as a bonus, free. All you have to do to download the MP3s is to click the track button, download track, and then enter your email. This gives you permission to get the download. It'll be sent directly to your inbox, and then you save the MP3 to your phone or to your like Google Drive, or however you save your MP3s. And that's a gift from me to you, because I really feel like if I can help anybody in any way, that's something that really might make a difference. And so I really hope you enjoy it. And if you want, I have another library of MP3s. I'm going to have some more courses, and I'm also offering one-to-one services on how to help clear your clutter, either via in person or over the computer, where I can help you get through an obstacle in your space and in your house, and help you break down what it takes to organize it or declutter it or say goodbye to some things, maybe come up with a real reason as to why you're holding on to stuff, and this way you can move forward or achieve your goal. I really hope that you enjoy this. I hope that the next 40 days or however you're approaching this is helpful for you, and I look forward to connecting with you. Have a great day.